Imagine a day when the sky turns ominous and the wind carries a hint of danger. This was the reality for millions on April 27, 2011, during the super outbreak. A day that went down in history as one of the most significant and destructive tornado outbreaks ever recorded. Spanning over 3 days from April 25th to 28th, the super outbreak unleashed a staggering total of 362 tornadoes across a broad expanse of the United States, affecting regions from the deep south to the northeastern states. This catastrophic event was unprecedented in its scale and intensity, leaving a trail of destruction in its wake. It marked a pivotal moment in our understanding of severe weather phenomena and underscored the dire need for advancements in meteorological forecasting and emergency preparedness. So, buckle up and join us as we journey through the timeline of this catastrophic event. What were the atmospheric ingredients that brewed this deadly storm? The 2011 super outbreak was a perfect storm of meteorological conditions, each playing a vital role in creating the most devastating tornado outbreak in history. To understand this catastrophic event, let's delve into the atmospheric conditions that set the stage. The key ingredients for the formation of such a destructive tornado outbreak are a volatile mix of warm, moist air and cold, dry air. In the days leading up to the super outbreak, a massive low-pressure system developed over the Great Plains. This system was accompanied by a surge of warm, moist air from the Gulf of Mexico. This warm air is crucial because as it rises, it cools and condenses to form thunderstorm clouds. Meanwhile, a contrasting air mass, cold and dry, swept down from Canada. When this cold air collides with the rising warm air, it creates a battleground in the skies. The warm air is forced to rise rapidly over the cold air, generating powerful updrafts that can give birth to thunderstorms. But these were not just any thunderstorms. These were supercell thunderstorms, the most severe and potent of all thunderstorms. Supercells possess a unique characteristic, a rotating updraft called a mesocyclone. This rotation is a crucial step in the formation of a tornado. To add to this volatile mix, there were also strong wind shear conditions. Wind shear is the change in wind speed or direction with height. In the case of the super outbreak, there was significant speed and directional shear, providing the necessary spin to initiate the tornadoes. All these ingredients, the warm, moist air, the cold, dry air, the supercell thunderstorms, the mesocyclones, and the wind shear, came together in an explosive mix over the southern, midwestern, and northeastern United States. The result was the formation of an astounding 361 tornadoes across 21 states in just 4 days. These conditions set the stage for what would become history's deadliest tornado outbreak. April 27th, 2011, a day that will forever be etched in the annals of weather history. It was the peak of the super outbreak, a day that saw the full fury of Mother Nature unleashed. The sky turned a menacing shade of gray, and the air grew heavy with anticipation. The day dawned with a sense of foreboding. Meteorologists had warned of the potential for severe weather, but nothing could have prepared the residents of the southern, midwestern, and northeastern United States for what was to come. As the sun rose, the first tornadoes of the day began to touch down, their power and ferocity a harrowing preview of the hours ahead. Throughout the day, an astonishing 362 tornadoes would ravage communities across 21 states. The scale and intensity of the outbreak were unprecedented. Tornadoes of varying strengths from EF1 to EF5 tore across the landscape, leaving a trail of destruction in their wake. The sheer number of tornadoes was staggering, but what was even more alarming was the intensity of these storms. An unprecedented number of tornadoes reached EF4 and EF5 status, the highest levels on the enhanced Fujita scale. These powerful twisters were not just quick, passing threats. Many of them were long-track tornadoes, staying on the ground for dozens of miles and causing extensive damage. The landscape was transformed in a matter of hours as homes, schools, and businesses were reduced to rubble. But amid the chaos and devastation, there were also stories of survival. People huddled together in basements and storm shelters, holding onto each other as their world was torn apart above them. They emerged to a scene of destruction, but they were alive. It was a testament to the power of preparedness and a stark reminder of the indiscriminate power of nature. As the sun set on April 27, 2011, the people affected by the day's events faced a daunting reality. Their homes and communities had been ravaged, their lives upended, but they were not defeated. In the face of relentless tornadoes, communities braced for impact.
and when the dust settled, they began the long process of recovery.
The tornadoes left in their wake a trail of destruction and heartbreak. Communities that once thrived were reduced to rubble within moments. The landscape changed dramatically, as if the earth itself had been rearranged by an unseen hand. Homes, schools, businesses, all bore the brunt of the tornado's fierce power. The loss of life was staggering. The tornadoes claimed hundreds of lives, leaving families and friends in a state of shock and grief. Each life lost was a story cut short, a person loved and missed. The number of injuries ran into the thousands, with many survivors facing long recoveries and the challenge of rebuilding their lives. Beyond the human toll, the tornadoes left a significant imprint on the built environment. Buildings were flattened, infrastructure was damaged, and entire neighborhoods were wiped off the map. The economic cost was immense, running into the billions of dollars. This was not just about physical structures, though. These were people's homes, their places of work, their community hubs. Each demolished building represented a piece of a community's soul. The tornadoes also disrupted everyday life in ways big and small. Schools were closed, businesses were shuttered, and essential services were interrupted. For those directly affected, the rhythm of daily life was thrown into chaos. For those on the periphery, a sense of unease and uncertainty permeated their days. Yet amidst the devastation, there were glimmers of hope. Stories emerged of strangers helping strangers, of communities coming together to support their members. The tornadoes had taken much away, but they could not take away the resilience of the human spirit. The landscape was forever changed, but the human spirit remained unbroken. In the face of unimaginable loss, communities found within themselves the strength to recover, rebuild, and even in time to thrive once more. In the face of adversity, the human spirit shines brightest. This statement couldn't be truer when we remember the days following the 2011 super outbreak. Amidst the wreckage and despair, stories of resilience began to emerge, painting a picture of hope in a landscape of devastation. Take, for example, the small town of Smithville, Mississippi. The town was nearly wiped off the map by an EF5 tornado, yet its residents refused to be defeated. They banded together, clearing debris, sharing resources, and comforting each other through the unimaginable. Their spirit of resilience was so strong that it even caught the attention of national media. Then, there were the first responders and volunteers who worked tirelessly, often putting their own needs aside to help others. They searched for survivors, provided medical care, and distributed much-needed supplies. Their selflessness was a beacon of light in a time of darkness. And who can forget the story of Tuscaloosa? After being hit by a massive tornado, this city not only rebuilt, but it also became a symbol of strength and recovery for other affected communities. Their motto, "We will come back stronger," became a rallying cry for the whole region. There was also an overwhelming outpouring of support from around the nation. People from all walks of life donated time, money, and supplies to aid in the recovery efforts. This solidarity was a testament to the kindness and generosity that often arise in times of crisis. But perhaps the most powerful story of resilience came from the survivors themselves. Despite the loss and heartbreak, they got up each day determined to rebuild their lives. Their courage and determination were nothing short of inspiring. In the aftermath of such a devastating event, it would have been easy for these communities to lose hope, but they didn't. Instead, they chose to face the challenge head-on, proving that the human spirit is indeed resilient. The road to recovery was long, but the resilience of these communities was inspiring. It serves as a reminder that even in the face of the most powerful tornadoes, the human spirit remains unbroken. Every storm brings lessons, and the 2011 super outbreak was no exception. In the aftermath of this catastrophic event, meteorologists, emergency managers, and communities collectively reflected on what could have been done differently, paving the way for significant advancements in severe weather preparedness and response. One area that saw significant improvement was in forecasting. Today's meteorologists have the benefit of advanced radar technology and storm prediction models that provide more accurate and timely predictions. These tools allow for earlier tornado warnings, giving people more time to take cover. Emergency management has also seen a shift. The 2011 super outbreak underscored the importance of having a well-coordinated disaster response plan. Today, emergency managers work closely with meteorologists, local government officials, and community organizations to ensure that when severe weather strikes, resources and personnel are ready to respond. Community resilience has also been a focus. The super outbreak highlighted the need for individuals and communities to be prepared for severe weather. This has led to increased efforts to educate the public about tornado safety and preparedness, from understanding tornado warnings to knowing where to seek shelter. The lessons learned from the 2011 super outbreak have also driven advancements in tornado prediction and tracking technology. Researchers have been working tirelessly to improve our understanding of tornadoes, resulting in more sophisticated prediction models and radar technology. These advancements have significantly improved tornado warning systems, providing communities with more time to prepare and potentially saving lives. In addition, social media and mobile technology now play a crucial role in disseminating weather warnings and updates. This technology wasn't as widely used in 2011, but today, it's an integral part of severe weather communication, providing real-time updates and allowing people to share information quickly and efficiently. The 2011 super outbreak was a stark reminder of nature's destructive power, but it also served as a catalyst for positive change. The lessons learned have led to improved forecasting, more effective emergency management, and stronger community resilience. The lessons from the super outbreak have shaped the way we prepare for and respond to severe weather events. The 2011 super outbreak was a stark reminder of nature's power and unpredictability. This devastating event, marked as the largest and one of the deadliest tornado outbreaks in history, served as a wake-up call to meteorologists, emergency responders, and communities alike. Over the course of this video, we've taken a comprehensive look at the 2011 super outbreak, from the meteorological conditions that led to its formation to the peak of the outbreak on April 27th. We've delved into the impact of the tornadoes on communities, with a particular focus on the Tuscaloosa and Joplin tornadoes, and the heartbreaking tally of lives lost and injuries sustained. We've also explored the human spirit and resilience in the face of such adversity. The stories of survival, recovery, and solidarity among affected communities are a testament to the indomitable will of the human spirit. Amidst the devastation, there were also lessons to be learned and advances to be made in the field of meteorology. The 2011 super outbreak underscored the importance of accurate forecasting, effective communication of tornado warnings, and community preparedness. It led to significant improvements in tornado prediction and tracking technology, enhancing our ability to mitigate the impact of such severe weather events in the future. However, the key takeaway from this examination of the 2011 super outbreak is the critical importance of being prepared for severe weather events. It's essential to have a tornado plan in place, a safe shelter to retreat to, and an understanding of the warning signs of an impending tornado. In concluding, the 2011 super outbreak stands as a stark reminder of the power of nature. It underscores the importance of preparedness, the value of scientific advancements, and the indomitable strength of the human spirit in the face of adversity. While we cannot control the weather, we can learn, prepare, and stand resilient in the face of adversity. Thank you for joining us on this journey through the 2011 super outbreak. It's been a deep dive into one of the most significant weather events of recent history. We've explored the meteorological phenomena that led to the outbreak, the devastating impact on communities, and the inspiring resilience of the human spirit in the aftermath. By understanding the circumstances and consequences of such events, we can better appreciate the power of nature and the importance of being prepared. It's our hope that this exploration has not just informed, but also inspired you to take an active interest in the world around you, especially the often overlooked realm of weather. In the spirit of learning, let's keep the conversation going. If you have any thoughts, questions, or insights to share, we encourage you to leave a comment below. Your participation helps us all learn more and deepens our collective understanding. If you found this video enlightening, why not share it? By passing on this information, you can help others gain a better understanding of these powerful natural phenomena. After all, knowledge is most beneficial when it's shared. Remember to hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. Your likes help us reach a wider audience and spread the important message of weather awareness and preparedness. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Subscribing ensures you won't miss any of our upcoming content. We have a wide range of videos planned that delve into various aspects of weather, from the science behind it to its impact on our daily lives. And remember, the more we understand about the world around us, the better equipped we are to navigate it. Weather is a part of our lives, whether we're weather enthusiasts or not, and understanding it can only serve to enhance our experience of the world. Stay safe, stay informed, and remember, knowledge is the first step to preparedness.